Jack. Hey,
Jack. Hey, how you doing?
Hi, I'm Joel.
Hey, hello.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, man.
Adam, I'll tell you from here, okay?
Yes. Adam? It's like the first guy ever.
Yeah.
Adam.
The first man.
He's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's...
Suicide Squad are all tough guys, tough girls, so who is the toughest one? Who is like the guy who can kick ass, Batman ass, like in a second? It's like Rick Flag?
Yeah, Karen Fugihara.
I think probably Karen Fugihara.
Yeah.
She's the one. She's dangerous.
Yeah, she took it very seriously.
Too seriously.
Yeah, you know. She like has her own sword.
Yeah.
She could like literally...
Sashimi.
Yeah, cut people in half.
She literally cut my masculinity off.
Yeah.
I mean, not.
No. That is like Rick Flag. He must manage all the crazy stuff out there, you know. So Rick Flag is like the second toughest man in the whole movie.
Second?
Yeah.
This is not going well. This interview is not going well.
Yeah. Now, Flag is pretty tough. I think Flag was pretty tough.
He's in a bad mood,
yeah.
So it kind of comes off a little hard.
What was for you the most important thing during the shooting, the action, and the fights? What was on the set the most important thing for you?
To not get hurt.
Yeah.
Safety.
Safety first.
With this cast and with the director, David Ayer, everything was... so authentic, you know. He wanted everything to be practical and real. Yeah, even for Deadshot, the actual wrist magnums were real, you know. So it's like they were, you know, we're firing blanks and things like that. So we had to be very, very
cautious
on the set. Yes, I think.
To me, it was the vicinity that I had to Scott Eastwood.
Right.
He had this amazing ability to, no matter where he was standing, the blanks that were flying out, they would go inside my shirt.
Yeah.
It was like cling, 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 cling. Right. It was like a video game, and he was winning. So every take, I'd be like, you know, in my tough guy mode, like shooting, and then I'd get one of those in there, and then I'd be like, and I'd do the chicken dance, and
yeah.
It was all
tragic. Those things are hot.
Those are very hot.
Suicide Squad is, I think, a different movie than the other comic book movies, you know? So do you think that people who, like, don't watch comic book movies often will like Suicide Squad?
Yeah, I think
we're hoping.
Yeah. They better.
You never know, right?
Themes are universal, you know? And look, the thing that shakes this up is clearly, you know, it's obviously the fact that, you know, we've got villains at the center of the story this time around. But you know, it's like, it's funny, it's heavy action.
Yeah, I think the thematic idea at the center of it will you know, carry people along. It's the idea, David Ayer referred to it as, it's not a movie of good versus evil, it's a movie of bad versus evil.
And
conceptually, the one thing that keeps a bad person from being evil is that one tether to humanity, that the one real superpower, which is love. And all of these characters are struggling with love pulling them back from the evil abyss. I just want to say, that was really well put.
That was so smooth.
That was well put.
You should enter the 2016 election. You should.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks, Adam.
Thank you, Adam. Thank you very much.
That was very lovely.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.